So here comes Rafael Soto from Spain on Invasor, and I think the crowd are going to get their money's worth from this guy alone. He is fantastic.
Oh, he stops immediately. There's a new idea. And transfixes the judges with that sexy sort of, I don't know, quite wasn't a smile, was it? And off he goes. Doesn't even bother to go up the centre line. He's doing his own thing big time. And this is what this is all about. You do what you want. There are 15 movements that you have to show the judges at some point during your 5.5 to 6 minute reprise. And they'll mark that on technical merit. Anything else you do, extra special things that I'm quite sure he's going to do, will just go towards the very valuable artistic impression marks and use of the music.
He so gets into this performance, Rafael. You can see him almost dancing along, and he has that very jaunty little set of his neck and head just kind of just forward.
I think it's probably because he's broken it, wouldn't you, once in his life, because it's set on quite different to anybody else's. So this lovely horse, who has been sixth in the World Games in Vesa, a stallion, 15 years old, and built of bricks, really, in his front end, and this is very much typical of the Andaluzian Lusitano-type horses, that in the last 10 years have really come into their own in the eyes of dressage judges. They now judge them for what brilliance they have, rather than trying to compare them to the completely different mechanics of the German and Dutch and Swedish horses. The Mediterranean horse is a different beast, hinged together differently, but every bit as brilliant in his own way, as we see Invasor doing his passage. Has to execute a certain amount of steps. He can do more, but he must do a certain amount. 20 to be exact. And a lot of passage we'll see, because it's such a... You see his... just to keep the soles of his back feet, I think he's got solid plates on them. I don't think he's just got normal horseshoe. We'll have a look in a minute if we get another glance at it. As he's doing passage... Was that half? It is. He's going sideways in passage. My goodness. He's not asked to do that. That's a special one. Nor is he asked to do a pirouette in Piaf. Piaf, these horses are brilliant at passage in Piaf, because they have such huge, concentrated power in a very small area. They're not very big. 15-2. Rafael is not a big man.
Rafael Soto from Spain, halfway through his Grand Prix freestyle test to music and giving the crowd their money's worth. He is, as Lucinda said, a showman of note. And if I was handing out medals, there'd be a gold for him just for turning up.
Yeah.
He's brilliant. Look at him, just jumping up and down. So enjoying himself as things calm down and quieten down for Invasor.
Two bits there of the double bridle that's obligatory, clearly visible. This horse much lighter, it seems to me, than the one we just saw. The Dutch. Gathering him up, and Vasa's saying, now what next? He probably knows, because he's probably practiced many times to this music.
Change of gear, up the pace.
And into a lovely canter half pass. Really bounds through these half passes, light off the ground. Even though they're such heavy set horses through their neck and shoulder, they've got incredible use of their bodies. Now into his two-time changes. This is very much the way Rafael, or Paolo, as his nickname is, does everything in his flying changes. He terrifically exaggerates his body moves. You see him swinging from side to side, which doesn't give him the best marks for how he sits and does the job, but that's what his horse understands. And those are the messages he's taught him to listen to. commands during the test, but I don't think he's commanding his horse. He's just enjoying himself. Single changes on a circle. I can't quite tell if it's a circle getting the full width of the arena or a smaller circle. 20 metres wide, remember, it's not very wide. As he comes from that into one of the obligatory pirouettes. Now, some of them have done one and a half, some two. He's quite happy just to do one.
I like the way he looked up then, almost to say to the crowd, come on,
yes,
clap
let's have
along.
Some cheer. Exactly. It's just what it's like the athletes who are waiting to do their high jump, wanting everybody to cheer him. Okay, so 15 years old, could probably do with a bit of a hand from the crowd as he goes into extended count and comes straight back. He's going to do another pirouette. What is he doing? Oh, good heavens, he changed from extended canter into Piaf and turned around all in one go. Oh, look at this. Come on, everybody.
There he is. Come on, clap along.
Clap along. Look, he's asking them to join in. Isn't that just... I love this. This is theatre. This is what dressage is all about. Entertaining. It's not just the technical brilliance, which from what little I know is pretty extraordinarily good. I want this Spanish walk.
Olé!
Irresistible. His uncle's a prize bullfighter, and you can really see that, can't you?
Rafael Soto, who has brought unbridled joy to the dressage arena, punches the air. Gosh, does he have some fun. He is a genius in my eyes. He's brilliant.
Oh, gosh, I'm quite lifted by that, and that's what it should be, shouldn't it? You should feel great from watching this, not miserable.